gentlemen, viewers and subscribers, welcome to another edition, or another episode, I should say, of learning the Ibanez GSR 200 bass guitar. It's been a long time in between episodes. Since the last episode, we've had the following: the death of the pet of our family, the death of my brother-in-law, my wife being hospitalized for 3 weeks, and last but not least, a hurricane moving through the state. And let me tell you, we are in an evacuation zone, so we live right on the coast in Holiday, Florida, which is just outside of Tampa, and we had to evacuate. And let me tell you something, I have a large bed pickup truck and a car, and the bass, the amp, the keyboards that are just here off camera, everything went into those vehicles and went to my mom and dad's house. I wasn't leaving anything for the looters, because at the time we were under the impression that the hurricane was going to come right up the west coast and make a direct hit on Tampa, Holiday. Actually, they had the eye coming right over Holiday, but that did not happen. It ended up going up the center of the state pretty much, so I ended up actually evacuating closer to the hurricane. So be that as it may, all that's done now. We're getting back on the program. I'm getting back on filming my episodes. So this will be episode number 7. Welcome back. This is episode number 7, learning the Ibanez GSR 200 bass guitar. Now, a lot of time has transpired between episode 6 and episode 7 because of the reasons that I gave at the beginning of the video. So at episode number 6, I had basically learned only one song, which was Pink Floyd's Comfortably Numb, and I had not yet committed it 100% to memory, even though I did a cover of it. I made a couple of mistakes on the cover, and I was still having to read the tabs. Now I have that one totally committed to memory. And also, here's one that you might recognize that I also have committed to memory, and here goes. Recognize that tune, but if you don't, of course that's U2's With or Without You. I'm also working on another tune. Perhaps you can recognize it by the opening sequence. 1, 2, 3, 4. Recognize it yet? 1980s. Didn't recognize that. It is one of the tunes in the movie Breakfast Club, and it is by Simple Minds. And let's see, Don't You Forget About Me is the name of that tune. And I've got one other one committed. This one, I'm still working on my finger work. And I don't know if you noticed, but I've learned how to, if I'm playing on the lower strings, drop my thumb down to the top string to silence it. That is one skill that you absolutely have to master, because most of your noise From the strings, it's going to come from the E string. So, oh, and by the way, one other thing, you probably can't see it, but there's a Casio LK100 keyboard sitting right here off camera. You might be able to see a piece of it. My wife is learning how to play keyboards, and I also have a conversion chart here. Conversion chart that translates the bass tabs to notes for the piano or organ or however you want to use it. We actually use the organ feature most of all on that. And one thing that that does, if you're learning to read, trying to learn to read music like I am, it actually is a great benefit to have the keyboards there, because you can't see it, but I got some clear vinyl note tablatures, and every key has the note on it. So when I go to look up to see what I'm playing, like for instance for Comfortably Numb, my wife plays the keyboard part while I play the bass part, and then we got the rest coming on the computer, the vocal and what have you. But when I translate it, I can see what note I'm playing from the keyboard. It's pretty nifty if you're trying to learn how to read music, because I got the note sitting right there. Okay, here's one more that I'm working on. This is a old Vietnam era song. Perhaps you can recognize it. I'm playing it a little slower than it actually needs to be played, but you should be able to recognize it by the notes. Fortunate Son. Now, as far as my learning this bass, I've got the E string, the E and the A pretty much all the time. Most of the music that I'm playing right now involves the E and the A and a little bit of the D. A little bit of the D every once in a while. But I have yet to play a song that incorporates the G. Hopefully, I'll be getting to that soon, but as of right now, most of the music that I'm working on incorporates the E and the A almost exclusively, with a little bit of D thrown in here and there. But the songs that incorporate the D, I have not yet committed to memory. I have to follow the tabs. So anyway, that's pretty much where I'm at as far as learning the bass guitar. So I'll see you in a minute in the next part of our episode. Okay, that's it for episode number 7. I didn't want to make it too long-winded. One thing I do want to add, though, if you haven't watched my music studio video that I did pretty much the same time I did this one, from now on, when I do covers, I'm going to have a pretty impressive live show. I recommend that you watch my music studio video. You can see all the lights that I've installed in this room. I've got two lights up above here, rotating lights facing in both directions of the room. I got a waterfall effect light back there, and multicolored lights everywhere that can be controlled on a board that my wife has been taught how to use, where she can, just like on a stage, control the lighting. The wife being the keyboard player / lighting engineer. Anyway, that's it for episode 7. I hope you enjoyed it. As much as I enjoy doing it. By the time I do episode 8, I'll probably have another bass guitar in my collection. I've got it bookmarked on my computer, and any minute now, after I get done with this video, I'm going to make the purchase. It's on sale at Guitar Center, cleaning out their warehouse, and it's a really good deal. So, and it's a passive bass also, which I want. This is an active bass. I want a passive bass to go along with it. So, anyway, be that as it may, episode 7, that's a wrap. Thank you for watching.